So you're getting ready for your next trip to Italy, but you don't know any word in Italian? Well, then you might want to watch this video. Ciao a tutti e benvenuti a un nuovo video. My name is Stefano and I am an Italian teacher. In today's video, we're going to talk about 25 words and sentences you absolutely need if you're coming to Italy. Alright, now it's time to get started with the first expressions of today. Greetings. Now, I've actually already uploaded a video about greetings, so you might want to go check that one first. So let's move on to the second expression of today. Grazie. Grazie. I'm sure that you know this word already, as it's very popular around the world, but just make sure you get the pronunciation right. It's grazie. Grazie. I want to hear that final E. Grazie. Now, grazie is very simple and it just means thank you. But if you want to be super nice, you could also say grazie mille. Grazie mille. That simply means thank you very much. Now, if someone says grazie to you, you might want to respond using prego. Prego. You're welcome. Now, prego has actually a lot of different meanings. So the first one is you're welcome, but it also means go ahead. So for example, if you're talking to someone and you want them to express their opinion or ask a question, you could say go ahead, prego, prego. You might also use it, for example, at the supermarket, at the entrance, where maybe there is an old lady or an old man close to you and you want them to get into the store first. So you say, prego, prego, go ahead. Last but not least, prego is also used when you are saying, come in. So for example, if a friend knocks on your door and you want them to come in, you could say, prego, prego, like, come in. Now let's talk about scusa. Scusa. Scusa means both sorry and excuse me. So we can use it both to apologize to someone, but also to get someone's attention. Now remember that scusa is informal, okay? That is very important. If you want to use the formal version, you're going to say scusi. Scusi. So you would use scusa with your friends, your family, people you know well, or eventually people your age, and scusi when you are in a formal setting. For example, at work, a university, or sometimes also in shops and restaurants. You could also add mi to scusa and scusi and say scusami, scusami, or mi scusi, mi scusi. In this case, you're just putting more emphasis on yourself. I would say that you can use both scusa and scusami or scusi and mi scusi interchangeably. Now, let's talk about mi dispiace. Mi dispiace. Now, remember that mi dispiace is used to apologize, but it's very, very emotional. Honestly, we actually use it, for example, when a friend of ours tells us a bad story or a sad story, so we feel sorry for him. And in that case, we would say, mi dispiace. Now, let's say, for example, that I'm telling you that I ran out of pasta and wine at my house. So you're going to say, mi dispiace, Stefano. Mi dispiace. Let's go to the next one. Per favore or per piacere. Per favore, per piacere. Honestly, these two are very easy. They simply mean please. They are totally interchangeable, so you could just use the one that you like the most. Now, let's say, for example, that you walk into a bar to get your caffè, and you say something like, scusi, prendo un caffè, per favore. Or, scusi, prendo un caffè, per piacere. That's a very useful sentence, write it down. And now, one of the most important expressions you need to memorize. Come ti chiami? Come ti chiami? Come ti chiami? Well, you wanna get to know people in Italy, so you wanna ask for their name. And come ti chiami simply means, what's your name? And how would you respond to that? Well, it's very easy. Mi chiamo Stefano. Mi chiamo Stefano. So, mi chiamo plus your name. And what if you want to ask something like, how are you? Well, that's very easy as well. Come stai? Come stai? Now remember that come stai is informal. So if you want to be formal, you just need to drop the final I and say come sta? Come sta? Now let me give you a few ways to respond to come stai. Sto bene, grazie. E tu? Sto bene, grazie. E tu? Sto benissimo, grazie. Sto benissimo, grazie. Sto alla grande, grazie. Sto alla grande, grazie. I love this last one, sto alla grande. I use it all the time. An alternative to come stai, how are you, would be come va? Come va? In this case, we're using va, that is the third person singular of the verb andare, to go. So basically, it's the same thing that you do in English with the expression how is it going? One way to respond to this would be va tutto bene, grazie. Va tutto bene, grazie. Alright, now let's start talking about some useful and very practical expressions that you might need to use. The first one is dove plus a place. Dove. Dove. Now, let's not kid ourselves. You're not going to use this expression to ask for directions. That's because everybody uses phones, so asking for directions is not a thing anymore. If you still ask for directions or you plan to ask directions in Italy, I think that's a great way to practice your Italian with native speakers. But most of the time, you would use this expression to ask things like dov'è il bagno? Dov'è il bagno? So let's say, for example, you are in a restaurant and you want to ask where the bathroom is. So you say, dov'è il bagno? Dov'è il bagno? Well, you can't use your phone for that. So remember, dov'è plus the place you want to go to. Now let's talk about money. Quanto costa? Quanto costa? We also use another expression for this, that is, quante? Quante? Quante is very common to use when you're asking for the total amount of money that you need to pay for your items. But if you just want to ask the specific price of an item, then you're going to say quanto costa? Quanto costa? Of course, an Italian is going to get back to you with numbers. So if you don't know numbers, you want to make sure you study them right away. I know numbers are kind of a pain, but knowing numbers when you go to a foreign country is very, very important. Now, let's say you are in an Italian bakery and you want to buy that amazing arancino that is staring at you. Well, in that case, you can just say, mi può dare un arancino? Mi può dare un arancino? Now, if you don't know how to pronounce or if you don't know the name of the item you want to buy, you can just say, mi può dare quello? Mi può dare quello? And just point your finger at the item. If you want to be nice, you can also add per favore or per piacere to this specific expression. But if you are in a restaurant and you want to order food, well, it's very easy. You can use the word vorrei. Vorrei. Now, vorrei means I would like. So you could say vorrei una lasagna. Grazie. Vorrei una lasagna, grazie. Or you could use the expression prendo. Prendo. Well, prendo means I'll have. Literally, I take. For example, in Italy, we don't really get or have coffees, we actually take them. So in a bar, I would say something like prendo un caffè, grazie. Prendo un caffè, grazie. Now let's say you're back at the restaurant and you want to ask for the check, the bill. What are you going to say then? Very easy. You're going to say, ci può portare il conto? Ci può portare il conto? Now what if you want to ask where a person is from? You're going to say, di dove sei? Di dove sei? Where are you from? And how do you answer to that question? You have two options. You either say, sono di plus the city you are from. For example, sono di Roma, sono di New York, or sono plus the adjective of nationality. For example, I would say sono italiano. So what you might want to do is to go on Word Reference, my favorite online dictionary, and look for your adjective of nationality. Now remember that if the adjective of nationality you find ends in O, then if you are a man, you're gonna leave it as it is. But if you're a woman, you're gonna change that O into A. So for instance, if you are an American man, you're going to say sono americano. But if you're a woman, you're going to say sono americana. But if the adjective of nationality you found ends in E, then you don't have to worry about changing it. So for example, you would say sono francese, I am French, both if you're a woman or a man. And then last expression of today. Scusami, non parlo molto bene l'italiano. Scusami. Non parlo molto bene l'italiano. This expression might be very useful if you want to switch to English. But let me tell you something. Yes, you don't speak Italian very well yet. So why don't you get started and learn this beautiful language? You can check out all my other videos on my channel. And don't forget to subscribe if you want to watch more. And also, if you've enjoyed this video and you want to support me, don't forget to like this video. That's gonna help me a lot. So I hope you enjoyed this little list of Italian expressions. What do you think? Which one was your favorite? Let me know in the comment section below. I'm going to see you in the next video. Ci vediamo nel prossimo video. Ciao ciao! Vado a comprare un po' di pasta e vino, allora, un secondo, eh.